such a bore. Nobody is going to, if we had of our ways, understand the secrets that we learned here tonight. You've all spent a lot of money to come to this lecture tonight to learn the secrets of what it's the difference between being a nice guy and a man that needs to be respected by the woman. Okay, so I was talking last week about the respect that we need to have the woman earn from us. We've talked about a problem with you last week, Paul. Paul, the problem went like this. I tried to test your faith to see if you can, you've been knowing that girl. Her name is Tracy, right? Tracy, right, Tracy. And you've known Tracy for 6 months now, 6 months, and you've been waiting to call her up and ask her out. Well, finally, Paul had the opportunity, the courage to go up and ask Tracy. It's his night class. He's taken over to the community college. Tracy, can I have your phone number? And she gave out the phone number to Paul. Now, he waited, what was it, 3 weeks? 3 weeks he waited. 3 weeks he waited to ask this girl out. So finally, he gets on the phone and asks her out. Hello, Tracy. Yes, Paul, how can I help you? Tracy, I just want to know if we can go out this weekend. And she said, yes, of course we can go out. Now the faith is coming in here. Logic has it that he has a date set with her this Saturday. Logic has it that when he calls up this Saturday, now the part of the plan is he's going to call up and say, Tracy, I'm going to have to break plans with you this Saturday. Logic has it that Tracy's going to be upset and become disinterested in Paul, right? That's logic. That's logic. But what reality is, Tracy's not going to be upset. In fact, the faith that Paul took to ask her to reschedule the date is going to make her more interested. She now has a stronger desire to go out with Paul the following week. We have put into her mind, make the woman earn your love. Together.
Make the woman earn your love.
The key word is earn, earn. Paul, placing that phone call and postponing the date until the week later, has now made Tracy earn his love. Earn his love. They need us in their lives, controlling them at every moment, every minute, no matter what they say. We have to think that all women are alike, and that is the truth. They're all alike, and that's why we are here tonight to learn at
Nice Guys Anonymous.
Now, let's go over those one-liners that we talked about last week. Let's see, who's up first? Oh, yes, Chris.
Okay, I know we've been dating for a while now, but there's still something missing, and I'm going to need some time to sort things out.
Dwayne, yes.
Look, if you want a friend, get a dog. I didn't spend hundreds of dollars on dinners and entertainment just because I thought you were bored.
Armand.
Hey, where are you going? Get back in here. We are not finished yet. In my country, women aren't even allowed to drive. So put those keys down before I throw a burqa over you.
Very well done, very well done. Okay, Paul, you have something to say?
I don't need you anyway. Why, I can pick up the phone right now and call 5 or 6 girls who would really know how to love a man.
Yeah, right. I've noticed we have a new face in the audience here today. What is your name?
Hi, my name's Erik.
Erik, would everyone mind turning around and saying hello to Erik?
Ah!
Erik, we would like to welcome you to
Nice Guys Anonymous.
Yes, thank you. Would you mind, Erik, explaining to us your confidential story, why you happen to be here?
Well, I
think this is the last of it here.
Oh, Erik, thank you so much for moving that. It looks heavy.
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah. Can I?
Yeah. Erik, you are such a nice guy.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you so much for helping me move in. That was, I just appreciate it so much. And I know my armor was really heavy, and you had to move that by yourself, and then the couch up the stairs around the corner.
Yeah.
I'm sure that was so hard. And I'm so sorry no one else came from the Elder's Quorum. I guess I should have told them, but I just forgot. I knew you were coming. You're so nice.
Oh,
I mean, I know my armor was really heavy, and then you had to move the couch up the stairs by yourself. You know, I'm so sorry no one else came. I think that maybe the Elder's Quorum would have come if I had told him, but I forgot. But I knew you were coming because you're such a nice guy, so I thought it would be okay.
I've been so grateful that I've been able to spend these last 6 hours with you. It's been so neat to get to know you a little bit better and help you move everything in.
You are so sweet.
Yeah.
That is so nice. Thanks. And I just, and I know moving my computer and all the desk and everything to by yourself, that was so heavy, and just my back hard.
Oh, no problem.
So
you know, anything
you.
I can do to help you out, it makes me real happy.
But thank you so much. Do you want some water?
Oh, I would love a glass of water. Thank you.
Okay, I'll be right back.
Okay.
Here's some water.
Oh, yeah.
You know,
thank
I
you.
Just have the tap water. It's kind of rusty, but I think it's okay. I drink it all the time.
Okay.
So, should be okay.
Mm. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
So, you know, I've had a lot of fun here today, spending time helping you move, like I said.
Really?
I was just wondering, what does your week look like this week?
Oh, my life is packing. I'm just packing and unpacking. And I'll be packing tonight, or unpacking tonight, until probably midnight.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't even know if I'm going to make it to church, because I still have some stuff at the other place. And I'll make it to Saturday. But I'm just going to be still doing things. I still have some things at the other place right now. And so just going back and forth is just crazy.
Because I was just wondering, like, maybe if
oh,
we could...
Oh, my phone is working!
Oh.
Oh, good!
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's working!
Hello?
Hello? Can I help you?
Yeah, I am Franz. I'm looking for Sarah.
Hans?
Franz, yeah, Franz.
Franz, okay.
Yeah. Looks good.
I've been helping Sarah move all day today.
Nice guy.
Thank you.
Yeah. Sarah!
Oh my gosh, Franz!
Sarah!
Hi!
How are you? How are you?
I'm good!
Good? So Looks good.
Yeah, Erik is such a nice guy. He moved in everything by himself.
Nice guy! You moved in, yeah?
Yeah, so what have you been doing today?
I was at the beach working out.
Really?
Surfing, volleyball. It was a great day, lots of sunshine. It was great.
Wow, your muscle is so strong, huh?
Are you ready for tonight?
Yes, what time do you want me to be ready to go?
An hour and a half.
Okay, I'll be ready.
Great, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
I'll be
great.
Ready.
Great, I'll see you tonight. Bye. Good job.
Bye, friends.
Bye.
Well, Erik, thank you so much for your help today. I couldn't have done this with you.
Yeah,
I just appreciate
no problem.
It so much.
It's been my pleasure.
Steph, I've got to jump in the shower and get ready. I've only got an hour and a half.
Yeah, you got a lot to do with that. Yeah,
jump and get ready. But anyway, well, just if you want to stay for a few, go ahead.
Yeah.
But I've had you the whole day. And so you can just go and get to your things. And
I'm going
to just hurry up and get ready. And
yeah, don't worry about it. Have fun. Yeah.
Okay, thanks, Erik.
Okay.
All right, I'll see you Sunday.
All right, yeah, we'll see you. Okay.